Good morning, students. Let's continue with the chapter Magnetic Effects of Current. So in this chapter we have studied about magnetic field. Magnetic field is the region of space around a magnet or around a current carrying wire in which its magnetic force or the magnetic effect can be experienced. Okay, in this magnetic field, few imaginary lines which may be curved, straight, okay, generally they are curved. So some imaginary lines could be drawn which gives the direction of the magnetic field. These lines are called as the magnetic field lines. Okay, and the tangent to these magnetic field lines gives the direction of the magnetic field at a particular point. So then we have studied the properties of magnetic field lines. Okay, they never cross each other, they never intersect each other, because at a particular point there is only one direction of the magnetic field. If they intersect, then at the point of intersection there will be two directions of the magnetic field, so that is why they cannot intersect each other. Okay, also where they are crowded, there the magnetic field is strong. Okay, and like near the poles of a bar magnet, the magnetic field lines are much crowded, so there at the poles the strength of the magnetic field is more as compared to the magnetic field at the center of the bar magnet. Okay, at the center the magnetic field lines are far apart from each other. Okay, magnetic field is a vector quantity, that is it has got magnitude as well as direction. Okay, so these are some of the properties which we have studied. Then we had drawn the pattern of the magnetic field lines for a bar magnet. Okay, and how is the pattern? Outside the magnet, they are traveling from north to south pole, some curved lines. Okay, north to south pole they are traveling, and inside the magnet, they are traveling from south to north pole. So, they form closed loops. So, magnetic field lines are forming closed loops. Okay, and at the poles, the magnetic field lines are much crowded as compared to the center. And this pattern could also be seen by doing an activity. Keeping a magnet on a cardboard, okay, a white sheet of paper is placed on the cardboard and the magnet at the and some iron fillings are sprinkled on this white sheet, and a magnet is kept below this cardboard. Gently tap it, you will see that all these iron fillings, they will arrange themselves in a particular pattern, like some curved lines. These curved lines are the magnetic field lines. Then for a bar magnet, we had drawn the magnetic field lines using the compass needle. Okay, so I have given the question also based on it. Okay, the pattern also you should know, how are the magnetic field lines for a bar magnet. Okay, now let's read it, what is given in the book. Page number 225, activity we had done. Okay, then below this blue box, magnetic field is a quantity that has both direction and magnitude. That is, magnetic field is a vector quantity. Okay, it has got magnitude as well as direction. The direction of the magnetic field is taken to be the direction in which a north pole of the compass needle moves inside it. Therefore, it is taken by convention that the field lines emerge from the north pole and merge at the south pole. So they are emerging from the north pole and merging at the south pole, that is terminating at the south pole. So outside the magnet, they are from north to south pole. Okay, note the arrows are marked on the field lines. So again, I am repeating, these arrows are very, very important. So whenever you draw the magnetic field lines for a bar magnet or for any other thing which we will be discussing right now. Okay, so this arrows are very, very important, which gives the direction of the magnetic field lines. Okay, inside the magnet, the direction of the magnetic field lines is from south to the north pole. So inside the magnet, they are traveling from south to north pole. Thus, the magnetic field lines are closed curves. So they are forming closed loops, or you may say they are closed curves, because outside north to south pole and inside they are traveling from south to north pole. The relative strength of the magnetic field is shown by the degree of closeness of the field lines. Okay, so the strength of the magnetic field is determined by the closeness of the magnetic field lines. Where they are much closer, there the magnetic field is very strong, and where they are far apart, there the magnetic field is weak. The field is stronger That is the force acting on the pole of another magnet placed is greater where the field lines are crowded. So the crowdedness or the closeness of the magnetic field lines gives the strength of the magnetic field. No two field lines are found to cross each other. Okay, that is no two field lines can ever intersect. If they did, it would mean that at the point of intersection, the compass needle will point towards two directions, which is not at all possible. Okay, so if they are intersecting, then at the point of intersection, there will be two directions of the magnetic field. Okay, that is if you place the compass needle at the point of intersection, it should point along two directions, which is not at all possible. So that is why two magnetic field lines can never intersect. Okay, these are some of the properties which we have already studied and given a question also based on it. So this you have already completed. Now the next topic is magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor. Okay, this was for a bar magnet. We know that the magnetic field is the region of space around the magnet or around the current carrying wire. Okay, so around the bar magnet we have studied what is the pattern of the magnetic field lines. We have drawn the pattern of the magnetic field lines, studied an activity also how to find out the pattern of this magnetic field lines, how to draw all this for a bar magnet we have studied. Okay, now near a current carrying wire also there is some magnetic field. Okay, now here the next topic is we will study about the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor. In activity 13.1, we have seen that an electric current through a metallic conductor produces a magnetic field around it. In order to find the direction of the field produced, let us repeat the activity in the following way. Okay, so let's do an activity to show that what is the direction of the magnetic field lines near a current carrying wire. Okay, the activity 13.4 given on page 226. Take a long straight copper wire, two or three cells, each of 1.5 volt, and a plug key. Connect all of them in series as shown in figure 13.5A. Okay, see the figure. Below this blue box, there is a figure where there are three cells connected in series. Each is of 1.5 volt. So the total voltage source will be equal to 1.5 into 3. That is 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5. That is 4.5 volts. Okay, and a key is connected. Okay, also there is a wire which is connected in the gap. Okay. Place the straight wire parallel to and over a compass needle. Plug the key in the circuit. Observe the direction of the deflection of the north pole of the needle. If the current flows from north to south, as shown in the figure 13.5A, the north pole of the compass needle will move towards the east. Replace the cell connections in the circuit as shown in figure 13.5B. This would result the change of the direction of the current through the copper wire, that is from south to north. Observe the change in the direction of the deflection of the needle. You will see that now the needle moves in the opposite direction, that is towards the west. It means that the direction of the magnetic field produced by the electric current is also reversed. Okay, so the activity is you have to take three cells which you have to connect it in series. Okay, so in the first figure 13.5A, this side is the positive terminal and here is the negative terminal which is connected to a key. Okay, then here there is a gap XY in which a copper wire is connected, and below this wire, okay, below this XY copper wire, a magnetic compass needle is placed. Okay, this compass needle is placed below the wire. Okay, and we know that the magnetic compass needle is when no current is flowing through this wire, the magnetic compass needle is pointing towards north-south direction. Okay. But when the current is passed, that is when the key is inserted, the current is passed through XY wire, okay, along this direction, that is from north to south. Here it is seen that the north pole of the magnetic compass needle, the north pole of the magnetic compass needle will be deflected towards east. Okay, that is, you may say that it will be deflected towards right. Okay, so what is done? Once again, I repeat, 3 cells, each of 1.5 volt, are connected in series, which is connected to a key, and there is a gap XY. A copper wire is connected in this gap XY, or any other wire, any medium wire may be connected, micro, any alloying wire can also be connected. Okay, and a magnetic compass needle is placed under the wire. Okay, below the wire, the magnetic compass needle is placed. Okay, first the key is open, and you see that the magnetic compass needle is pointing towards north-south direction. Okay, so this end is the north, this end is the south of the compass needle. Now key is inserted and the current will pass through this. Current is passing from X to Y. This is the direction of the current, that is from north to south. What is seen? The magnetic compass needle, which is placed below this X, Y, Y. It will be the north pole of the magnetic compass needle will be deflected towards east. That is, the compass needle shows a deflection because there is some magnetic field created, or there is some magnetic field around this current carrying wire. Now in the next activity, what is done? The direction of the current is reversed. How can the direction of the current be reversed? By changing the terminals. Okay, now this side is the negative terminal and here is the positive terminal. Okay, the same circuit P, and this is the gap XY. Again, the same wire is connected between the gap, and the magnetic compass needle is placed under this XY wire, below the XY wire. Okay. Now the key is inserted. What will be the direction of the current? The direction of the current will be from Y to X. That is from south to north. So this is the direction of the current. Now this time when the key is inserted and the current is passed through the XY wire, we'll see that the north pole of the magnetic compass needle will be deflected towards west. That is, by reversing the direction of the current in the XY wire, the direction of the magnetic field is also reversed. Okay? Why? Because the compass needle now is showing the deflection in the opposite direction. Okay? And if the current is not passed, that is when the circuit is open, when the key is not inserted, the compass needle, the magnetic compass needle will not show any deflection. That is, the compass needle only shows the deflection when the current is passed through the XY wire. Okay, so this compass needle is giving the direction of the magnetic field. So when we reverse the direction of the current, the magnetic compass needle is also reversed in the opposite direction. That is, the direction of the magnetic field is also reversed. Okay. Okay, so this is the activity which shows that the direction of the magnetic field will be reversed when the direction of the current is reversed. Okay, so write a question. Write down. Give an activity to show that the direction of magnetic field through a current carrying wire can be reversed. Okay, so given activity to show that the direction of the magnetic field near a current carrying wire can be reversed. Okay, how can it be reversed? By changing the direction of the current, the direction of the magnetic field can be reversed. Okay, so this is the activity 13.4. Okay, so this activity you will give it along with the diagram. Okay, diagram, whenever you give the activity, diagrams are very, very important. So draw the diagrams along with it. Okay, then the next topic is magnetic field due to a current through a straight conductor. Okay, if the current is passing through a straight conductor, let us see what is the pattern of the magnetic field lines. Okay, we'll draw the pattern of the magnetic field lines, and this magnetic field is depending upon what factors. So we'll study in this particular topic. What determines the pattern of the magnetic field generated by a current through a conductor? Does the pattern depend upon the shape of the conductor? We shall investigate with an activity. Okay, we shall investigate this with an activity. We shall first consider the pattern of the magnetic field around the straight current carrying conductor. Okay, that is, the wire is flowing through a conductor. Okay, obviously the current will flow through a conducting wire only. Okay, so a conducting wire through which is straight and the current is passed through it, we know that there is some magnetic field around it. Now here in this activity, we'll study the pattern of the magnetic field lines around the current carrying conductor, straight current carrying conductor. Okay, take a battery. Okay, the activity 13.5, which will show the pattern of the magnetic field lines. Take a battery, 12 volt, a variable resistance, which is also called as a rheostat. Okay, a device which changes the resistance in the circuit, that device we call it as rheostat without changing the potential difference. An emitter, which ranges from 0 to 5 amperes, a plug key, and a long, straight, thick copper wire. Insert the thick copper wire through the center, normal to the plane of a rectangular cardboard. Take care that the cardboard is fixed and does not slide up or down. Okay, that is, the cardboard remains horizontal only. Connect the copper wire vertically between the points X and Y, as shown in figure 13.6A, in series with the battery, a plug and a key. Sprinkle some iron filings uniformly on the cardboard. You may use a salt sprinkler for this purpose. Keep the variable of the rheostat at a fixed position and note the current through the emitter. Close the key so that the current flows through the wire. Ensure that the copper wire placed between the points X and Y remains vertically straight. Gently tap the cardboard a few times. Observe the pattern of the iron filling. You would find that the iron fillings align themselves, showing a pattern of concentric circles around the copper wire. What do these concentric circles represent? They represent the magnetic field lines. So this pattern in which the iron fillings arrange themselves in form of concentric circles around the current carrying wire, these concentric circles are the magnetic field lines around the current carrying wire. How can the direction of the magnetic field be found? Place a compass at a point P over a circle. Observe the direction of the needle. The direction of the north pole of the compass needle would give the direction of the magnetic field lines produced by the electric current through the straight wire at a point P. Show the direction by an arrow. Thus, the direction of the magnetic field lines gets reversed if the direction of the current through the straight copper wire is reversed. Okay, so if the direction of the current is reversed, you will find that the direction of the magnetic field lines can also be reversed, which can be checked with the help of a magnetic compass needle. Okay, now let's study in detail. So here, a battery is taken, that is, a number of cells connected in series. Okay, now that in the book it is given that it is a 12 volt battery. Okay, so here a 12 volt battery is there. This is the positive terminal, negative terminal. Okay, this is, like, it is 12 volt battery. Not necessary that you have to take 12 volt only, it can be more than that, it can be less than that. Okay, and in this circuit, that is, these terminals of the battery are connected with the help of connecting wires to an emitter and to a variable resistance, which we call it as the rheostat. Okay, and to a key. So here an emitter is connected. Okay, and the circuit symbol for the emitter we have already studied. Okay, and this side will be the positive terminal of the emitter, and this side will be the negative terminal of the emitter, which is connected to a variable resistance, which is called as rheostat, and this is the circuit symbol of rheostat. Okay, this is the rheostat. which is connected to a key. Okay, all these devices are connected in series. We know that emitter is always connected in series in a circuit. And what is the function of the emitter? It measures the current in the circuit. Okay, and in this gap, XY, this is the gap, XY, in which a thick copper wire is connected. Okay, in this gap, XY, a thick copper wire is connected. Now, before connecting, what is done? This thick copper wire is passed through a cardboard. Okay, a hole is made at the center of the cardboard, and this XY wire is passed through that cardboard. Okay, this is the cardboard. Okay, this cardboard, which is perpendicular to the plane of the board. Okay, that is the thick copper wire XY is passing through the center of the cardboard. Now, it has to be placed in such a way that the cardboard remains horizontal. Okay, this cardboard doesn't slide here or there. It should remain horizontal. So, this thick copper wire XY wire, which is connected in the gap XY, before connecting in this gap, it is passed to the center of a cardboard and it is placed in such a manner that the cardboard remains horizontal. Okay, now what is done? Sprinkle some iron fillings on this cardboard. Okay, once again I repeat, a 12 volt battery which is connected in series to an emitter, to a MOSFET, to a key, and now there is a gap XY in which a thick copper wire is connected. But before connecting, this thick copper wire is passed through the center of this cardboard. A hole is made at the center of the cardboard and this copper wire is passed through the center of the cardboard. Now some iron fillings are sprinkled over this cardboard. Okay, now pass the current. How to pass the current? By inserting the key, the current will be passed. This will be the direction of the current, which can be, and this current can also be measured by the emitter. Okay. Now, what you will find? Gently tap this cardboard. Okay, but make sure that it remains horizontal only. It doesn't slide towards the right or towards the left. Okay, it remains horizontal only. You will see that these iron fillings will arrange themselves in concentric circles. These iron fillings will arrange themselves in concentric circles. What are these concentric circles? These are the magnetic field lines near a current carrying wire. Around the current carrying wire, these are the magnetic field lines. Okay, so when you sprinkle some iron fillings and pass the current by inserting the key, you will see that all these iron fillings will arrange themselves in concentric circles. Okay, that is a number of circles will be formed by this iron fillings. So these concentric circles are the magnetic field lines. Okay, now the direction of the magnetic field lines has to be determined, which can be determined with the help of a compass needle. Okay, so with the help of a compass needle, the direction of the magnetic field lines is determined. Okay, so we'll continue tomorrow. Okay, so for today we have studied that the magnetic field lines also exist near a current carrying wire, not only near a magnet, around a current carrying wire also there is some magnetic field. Okay, and this direction of the magnetic field can be reversed around the current carrying wire. How can the direction of the magnetic field be reversed? By changing the direction of, by reversing the direction of the current. Okay, then we were studying about the magnetic field for a straight current carrying wire. Pattern we have seen. What is the pattern? These are concentric circles around the current carrying wire. Okay, again they have got some direction. Direction we will study. What is the direction of the magnetic field lines around this current carrying wire? So in the next one, we'll continue with this chapter. So keep revising and also don't forget to write your name, class and section, okay, in the comments so that your attendance will be marked. Okay, thank you.